Well, I'm looking at the Fed reaction to various commodities, and while there was a knee-jerk reaction that we saw in gold and silver where there was some profit-taking, but it has rebounded since then, and we are looking at nearly a percentage point and more of gains back in case of gold and silver. Peter McGuire of XM Australia now joins us to talk further on that. Peter, hi. We do understand that as we get more deeper into December, the volumes go down, profit-taking starts, books start to wind up, people start going to holidays. So finally, one of the most important central banks meetings is done. We have ECB to tackle today. There's Bank of England and Bank of Japan as well still remaining before we can call it a day. But how are you reading the Fed really a statement? And do you think that the other central banks would be, taking cues from this?
Well, I think, and good afternoon, Manisha, I think a couple of things. Yes, certainly they would be. They've all waited to see what Big Brother's prepared to do, and that's come out of the blocks very aggressively when you're looking at what their time frame over the next 3 years, 22, 23 and 24, we're going to sit at around about 2.1% by the end of 24. Three rate rises next year, three the year after in 23 and two in 24. And we're going to take off the table around $30 billion a month as far as taper. So I think that that's really hit them all between the eyes, and they know how the 22 years going to look from the Fed's perspective, Manisha.
How do you look at the reaction for gold? Because now we are looking at, or perhaps working with, 2 to 3 interest rate hikes in the next year. How would you see gold reacting to all of that?
Well, I'm looking at the US dollar index as a 96.3, 96.4 handle. I still believe that the inflation story is going to be hard to manage. So I think that gold, in some ways, with it, rates going up, you would think that gold might come under a little bit of pressure. But with the inflation story the way it is, I'm thinking it could go even, quite significantly higher from here. So I'm not going to put a number out there, but I think that there's probably more upside as far as gold and silver are concerned. That's physical, that is. And I think that a lot of investors globally would be looking at putting more gold underneath their pillow, Manisha, and certainly underneath the bed.
Right. So what kind of numbers are you working for in gold? Because, the banks or the markets are totally divided when it comes to next year. We are looking at bullish cues and bullish forecasts for the first half of the next year. But the second half perhaps is when an interest rate hike would have kicked in. Not too many people believe that we are looking at highs in the second half of next year. Are you also dividing the next year? How are you looking at a range in gold prices?
Well, I think first off, you've got to see where we are in March and April and what that storyline is as far as inflation. If we're significantly higher or even, a couple of percentage point higher than what we are at the moment, then I think that's going to put even more fear as far as the Fed's concerned. And so they're sitting at the moment saying we're going to see 3 rate rises. I talked to different analysts out there, Manisha, and some are saying you could see 4 or 5 next year. So there's the story. And I think that you'll probably look at higher gold prices because of that inflation. So if they can get it under control, then that's a different matter. But if inflation gallops away from here, and it's going to be a very hard horse to corral, Manisha, I don't know what you do. And then you've got worrying about the stagflation fears also with COVID and whatever else.
So what is your own forecast now for gold and silver for 2022?
Well, I think sometime over the year, I wouldn't be surprised to take highs out that what we've, as far as all-time highs. So I think it's got that potential over the 22 year. As far as silver's concerned, look, I think that you're probably going to see further upside from here. Silver will probably put, the best part of $3 to $5, $6 on quickly, $22. So I'm thinking by this time next year or sometime in 22, you'll see probably a 28 or 29 handle for silver. You might see higher because the issues are inflation, Manisha, and how you wrap that all around. So silver and gold are a place to play. It's going to be very appeasing for the Indian market and the Indian investors, and they've got a love affair naturally, as along with the Chinese, for physical gold.
A final question. So while, of course, the macros will be in queue here, but for silver as well, we have seen a couple of years of deficit here. Are you looking at the same in next year? Or you think as pandemic, is kind of left behind, the minings are opening up, the production could increase?
Yeah, I think, it's a little bit like you would think probably from oil production. If the price goes higher, Manisha, you want to pull more out of the ground because you're going to get a higher price. As you know, it's got a long lifetime, silver and gold in the ground. I think it'll be around here a little bit longer than I'll be. So, if the price is high, then get the stuff out of the ground and sell it to market, and that's what investors are after. And price will dictate that to any miner. So higher price, more will be mined and more will come out of the ground and more will be bought, Manisha.